What is far infrared, and why is this topic so commonly misunderstood? I'm Johannes, one of the co-founders and managing CEOs of Clearlight Saunas International. For the last 9 years, we've enabled a lot of people to successfully understand the topic of infrared saunas, infrared therapy, hermetic heat stress. And today's video, I'll help you understand the topic of far infrared. What is far infrared? What are the different spectrums? Don't forget to like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, if you found the video helpful and it's actually enabled you with a deeper understanding. We'd love to hear from you in the comments below as well. So what is infrared and what is far infrared? The infrared spectrum is made up of three different wavelengths. You have far, mid, and near infrared. And each of these spectrums has different attributions that works differently on the human body. And it also has different wavelengths, which essentially helps to define how these work and what the sort of energy content of these different wavelengths is. Far infrared was first discovered in the 1970s in Japan, and it was back then already used to heat newborn babies in hospitals. Very gentle, 100% safe, no possibility of actually burning your skin because the energy intensity of that spectrum is quite low. In terms of wavelengths, these are commonly introduced in microns, so micrometer or nanometer. And if you looked at the far infrared spectrum, you're typically starting at 7 to 8 micrometer all the way up to 1,000 micrometer. The most important wavelength really for the topic that we're going to talk about today is the 9.4 microns. We typically refer to this as human wavelength. It's essentially when I rub my hands and I feel the heat, that's the type of wavelength that is being emitted from my skin. It doesn't penetrate very deep, probably only 1 millimeter or 2 millimeters deep, and it works quite successfully in raising the core body temperature in an infrared sauna. If we looked at middle infrared has a different type of wavelength. It sort of starts at 1.4 microns and goes obviously all the way up to 7 microns. So that's the second spectrum. It's still invisible light, so you don't actually see it, but you feel it. The heat is a bit more intense, so it's a shorter wavelength, and with the shortness, it's more energy essentially packed into this wavelength. The penetration into the skin is a little bit deeper, so it actually goes through the upper layers of the skin, but doesn't actually penetrate through the skin entirely. Experts believe it's up to 3 to 4 millimeters max that middle infrared can actually penetrate through the skin, and therefore it does a really good job at sort of, you know, reaching the deeper layers of the skin, but still not passing through it entirely. So it kind of helps with skin nourishment. There have been some studies on the effects of wound healing in terms of, you know, the exposure of middle infrared and whether there are any benefits when it comes to scars or wound healing. And generally, it's a really good addition to any type of heat treatment or infrared sauna. So the last spectrum of the three types of infrared is the near-infrared spectrum. Near-infrared has the deepest penetration of the three types of infrared. It's the shortest wavelength, has the highest energy distribution in that, and therefore penetrates the deepest. It's currently known that it penetrates up to 5 to 6 millimeters deep, so it definitely penetrates through the layers of the skin and kind of reaches the first levels of muscle, tissue, veins, etc. So it's known to be quite effective when it comes to raising the core temperature, which is one of the main things that we're really looking for in a sauna or an infrared sauna, to really trigger that hermetic stress response, which is a good stress, right? Through the increase of temperature, our body needs to start cooling itself. The results are an increase in heart rate, more blood flow, and essentially while we're relaxing in an infrared sauna, for instance, our body is actually busy working out, cooling, and we really get a workout in for the whole cardiovascular system. It's hard to say, or you can't just really say that one infrared spectrum is better than the other. They all work differently. They have different effects on the human body. Therefore, in your research, what you do actually want to look out for is a full spectrum technology, a full spectrum infrared sauna, at least when you look at a sauna and sort of that heat response. And full spectrum means that it's the full infrared spectrum. So it's a good distribution of far infrared, which is always going to be the basis just for the human wavelength and really effectively raising your core body temperature. But then you also want to have middle and near infrared in there because they have different benefits on the human body. They work differently. They have different penetration depth. And therefore, by combining all three types of infrared into one technology, you're literally getting the best of the entire infrared spectrum. So with that in mind, the important lesson for you is there are three different infrared spectrums, near, middle, and far. They all vary in terms of the energy, in terms of the penetration into the human body. They're perfectly safe, but nonetheless, you really need to make sure that you combine the three of them to have a successful and a beneficial infrared sauna experience for your health. I hope you've enjoyed this video on what is far infrared, some of the health benefits and the technical definitions of it. If you've enjoyed it, make sure you give us a like and subscribe down below. Ask questions in the comment sections. We'll obviously get back to you. And also make sure that you check out our YouTube channel. We have a lot of other videos on this topic, which we sincerely hope help you in understanding this topic a lot better. And we look forward to seeing you again in our YouTube channel.